moja tema današnje je izračunavanje gubitaka
The theme for today's presentation is the calculation of losses in hares in Vojvodina for the period from 1967 to 2011. Previous speakers spoke about the population abundance, and I have data concerning the abundance and harvest of hares in Vojvodina, and we chose these years because, as we have mentioned, Professor Jovanović has started that research 40 years ago, and today these researchers are still going on. You can see the data from 1972, where the suspension of hunt was enacted on the recommendation of Professor Jovanović. The suspension lasted for 2 years, but even during that period, based on the law on hunt, hunting was allowed in certain areas in order to collect samples. Concerning the abundance of hares in Vojvodina, it was between 200 and 300,000, and the harvest was up to 65,000. Up to World War II, in certain periods between the year 1930 and 1935, they wanted to put the hares into the category of the animals which cause damage, and the season lasted from September 15th to January 15th, and because they couldn't hunt all these animals, all the hunters could hunt more than 40 hares per 100 hectares. Concerning the balancing of the population in all regions, there is a lot of variability between Srem, Bačka and Banat. Last year was a crisis here because some organization had 40 to 50 hares per 100 hectares, while others had between 15 and 20 individuals per 100 hectares, and suspended the hunting for the second season. So we tried to calculate the losses during the period of reproduction, which is the loss from the counting on April 1st of this year and until the October 15th, which is the beginning of the season, the opening of the season. As for the losses in winter time, these are understood between the 15th of October up to April 1st. And these are the results of the calculation for 45 years. The table is very big, so we try to give the average results. And the average abundance of hares in Vojvodina in the period of 45 years was 258,000. The average of harvest was around 3,800,000. The losses in the period of reproduction were 31.4%, and using the same methodology, we had the second part which calculated the winter losses, which were between 32% for the same period. Why are the winter losses important? Because we want to be able to calculate the losses which happen in the period of reproduction, but also the period, the losses in the winter period, in order to determine the harvest quota, so as not to have a decline in the abundance of the population.
za naše uslove bio
so the minimum for our conditions was less 5 hairs per 100 hectares and now increased it to 8 hairs individuals per 100 hectares. So for the whole of Vojvodina, since the year 1967, in the crisis period, we did not hunt, well, we tried to determine the percentage of leverets in the population to determine the optimal harvest quota. Today we have organizations which have excellent populations, 25, 35 and 40 individuals per 100 hectares before the beginning of the hunting season. As for the results, they are given in the paper, and I just want to mention that in the conclusion that the winter losses in the period of reproduction are close because 31% and 32% are the losses in the reproduction period and in the winter losses. And they are used when determining the management plan and determining the harvest quota, which leads to the preservation of the hare population for years to come. Thank you very much.